So we're here, RockFest 2024. It's Thursday, so we just survived Wednesday. For those that know, if you get the 3-day tickets, which we do, you get to go to the Wednesday bonus bash. We're just going to chat about that for a little bit, and then we have keep going because we have tattoo appointments at 11 and all kinds of other cool stuff.
I have to do something here.
Assuming the microphone isn't on the bottom and we just covered it, but we will.
Maybe better?
Yeah, maybe.
All right.
Anyway, we'll see. Anyway, so you
I got to do my makeup so I don't scare everybody.
So we got here a little late, later than expected.
My fault.
It's okay.
As usual.
But we are so well prepared. It's insane. So we missed the actual first band, which was what, Feel?
I think that's what they said, yeah.
And our neighbors were saying that they were quite good. Mm-hmm. So we missed them. So
we feel bad about that.
And so when we got here, we got everything in the tent. First thing we did was went by a tattoo booth to get our appointment, which we did. And then we just kind of wandered. Well, and then Burning Witches was on. And they're from, I think, somewhere in Europe. I think they might be Swiss or something.
Oh, okay. I was wondering about that.
At least on the little informational thing I saw. And they were good. They were impressive.
They really were. Go ahead. Well, I'm just going to look at my notes.
I was going to say, because you took notes.
I did take some notes, so actually I could just give you my notes.
Oh, there we go.
This is what I have so far, but...
Okay, so Burning Witches, she has...
That's my non-professional opinion.
Her non-professional opinion. Good. Iron Maiden / Megadeth. I would throw a little bit of Priest in there. While we were still... outside of the tent, the first couple songs they did were a little bit more
screamy,
kind of shrieky, and then they settled into this really, really really, really almost like classic metal kind of vibe.
Yeah.
Like Megadeth, Iron Maiden, Judas Priest, just very almost traditional, but really freaking cool. Nice stage look and captivating. They were captivating. Because you don't see very many all-female, like, metal bands like that. So
yeah, they had a good stage like decor.
Presence,
like
yes.
It was really cool. Had a like a neat like kind of tied it all together. Together had a good theme.
Yeah,
So then I just go into the next band.
Okay, so that was on. It was on top, and then we went down to the Boneyard. And there was a band called Shallow Side, and they. We're assuming are very popular because the tent was absolutely
packed.
And so her notes are as follows. Kind of country, some covers, big following, good stage presence. It's Wednesday, not Thursday.
Yeah, he said.
Called themselves rednecks. From Alabama.
But very, they don't have a home, really, they said.
Yeah.
But wherever they are is their
wherever
home.
Wherever they are is home, which is a kind of a cliche.
So we're their home tonight.
To say.
That's what they said.
From Alabama, very tight, polished skillet. They were very skillet-like.
Yes. Yeah, so that's about all I had. But and then for Burning Witches, we were kind of bummed, actually, because we wanted to look at the merch.
Oh, yeah.
And so, we couldn't, they didn't have any.
So we went to the trailer where Who's On Top merch usually is, and they had nothing in there. Nothing for any of the bands, which I found a little weird. Because usually they have something. And then they have a spot just the side of the stage, kind of behind the trailer, where, like, additional merch, like, if bands don't want to put it in the trailer or whatever, they sell themselves or whatever, and there's nothing there. And then we kind of go around to the other side, and we see the singer, like, by their van, and there were people in line to, like, take pictures and stuff, so, and then Sheena was saying that she was trying to get a shirt.
But our fabulous neighbors. Glamping neighbors.
Was saying that she was trying to get a shirt, but all they had was like smalls and mediums. And I'm like, oh, so they were literally just selling merch out of their van. Which is a very, very rock and roll thing to do.
Hey, we've got ice. Thank you. We've got ice. Oh, yeah, you can all my password here.
Yeah.
Enjoy
your weekend. Your weekend doesn't start.
And we love our neighbors because they wake us up with wonderful music every morning. And
yes,
I'm a music person, and he's got to wake me up with music half the time. So we do appreciate your music.
Yes, absolutely. So then we wander back up to Who's on Top for Quiet Riot. And they...
not very impressed.
Not, yeah, it was not.
Yeah.
As much as we, put it to you this way, I would rather have watched Disturbed again than the Quiet Riot set.
Yes, and if
you remember how much we kind of dogged Disturbed, yeah, I'd much rather have watched Disturbed again than Quiet Riot. Yep. I mean, not that they weren't good, they were good, but...
just it was like, okay.
Yeah, yeah. It was like completely phoned in and just like no, I mean, the energy in the sense that they were jumping around and stuff, but like no heart behind it. I don't know. It was a really flat set. I don't know.
Yeah.
Especially compared to the next band we saw, which I was looking forward to. I know you were looking forward to. And they're from Colorado, I believe. And that's Psycho Stick.
Yes.
Psycho Stick was fucking amazing.
They were.
Yeah. That's all. I mean, it's everything you want in a metal set.
Yeah. Oh boy, entertaining, funny.
Entertaining. The humor's there. They're heavy as shit.
Oh
yeah. They want to be.
Oh motherfucker! Really?
Oh, is that one dry?
Oh, it just broke.
Oh.
Do that sometimes.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, well. Okay, sorry, people. I did Megaswore? I don't know. My eyeliner just broke, which is annoying. If you're a girl, you know that.
Or a guy.
Oh, I guess nowadays, especially. And musicians. All my musician peeps.
Yeah, so if you're not... if you don't mind a little humor in your music.
A lot of humor in your music.
A lot of humor in your music, let's face it.
I
mean, the first three songs are about...
Beards, boobs,
and then we'll
shower.
And then shower.
I think it was shower.
Which
now I wanted to shower so bad after that song.
And then they did their internet hit. I Can Only Count to Four, which they introduced as, for this next song, once you hear it, you'll be like, "That's them." And this one literally said, "That's them."
I know. I was being funny though.
Oh, were you?
Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. I was being funny.
So I was gonna say. Yeah. But yeah, I mean, they're just a really good time. If you're not familiar, hunt them out, see them live. They're awesome. And then Vince Neil was Vince Neil. He did what he did. Not nearly as bad as we were expecting.
Oh, almost made
so
it.
So close.
Oh, that was close.
On the rim.
Rim shot.
And then
it's different.
Yeah, and then we did run into the caster crew.
Yeah. Of course, I saw a million people that looked familiar, but I don't know.
Well, yeah.
If I just know them from last year or.
Yeah, I mean, we saw, I think, both of our seat neighbors.
Yes.
At various times last night, so it'll be good to catch up with them again. But yeah, so we did that, and we hung out with them, and
they get to see my arm for half of this. So that was good, and that was fun conversations as always.
As always, yep.
Our dear Caitlin and Alex. And,
yep, because you know Steven had to go to bed because.
You know, hey, we got invited in to check out one of the other campsites parties, And I had to tell the like 70-year-old guy that I was too old to party,
that we were
and I needed
too old
to go
party.
To bed.
And, he was
and
like,
he's
okay.
looking at me like, what?
Yeah.
I'm like, no, man, I got to go to bed. I got stuff tomorrow.
Maybe tomorrow night. Maybe we'll go tomorrow.
Yeah, but literally, he's like, he's 70, and I'm like, yeah, no, I got to go to bed. Sorry,
yeah,
dude.
Yeah. Mm. But RockFest, that's what you do. Yeah, so that was Wednesday night. So today, I mean, a bunch of bands, in no particular order that I remember off the top of my head, Cult is Black, who I am repping. You can't really see that, but Gabriel and the Apocalypse.
I'm excited to see because I've never seen them.
Yeah,
so.
I saw them once years ago at a CD release party at the Caboose, and they were really good. Gravesig.
Gravesig. Did we say Cowboys from Hell?
Cowboys from Hell. And that's just on the smaller stages. I mean, main stage, you got.
Here we go.
There we go.
Oh, Aaron Jones.
Yep, Aaron Jones.
Killswitch Engage, we're told, stoked.
Killswitch, Seven Dust, 311.
Yep.
I mean, those three alone are pretty killer.
You want to check up Dirty Honey?
Dirty Honey, I'm curious about.
Mm-hmm.
And then those are the only ones that I actually know. Like Upon a Burning Body, I've heard the name, but I don't really know anything by them.
Yeah.
Sleep Theory, I think I know the name.
Yeah.
So today should be a good day.
I'm really excited for Killswitch because, like, yeah. Oh, and 30 Seconds to Mars.
And 30 Seconds.
Yeah, I'm totally stoked to see them too. Like, absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
Sure. So yeah. So it's and then Lockjaw. I don't even know. And yeah.
Well, Lockjaw we'll probably miss anyway, so we'll be getting,
tattoos. Tapped. That's right.
But yeah, so.
I'm already hot. Yeah, so
so that's all we got for now.
Tattoo time, bitches.
Tattoo time, we gotta run. So, we'll probably check in tomorrow morning and we'll review today.
Yep.
If that makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh, we forgot to say that Vince Neil did not suck as bad as the internet. Did we say that?
True. I don't think we said that, but we'll say it again.
Oh, well, okay.
Just to emphasize.
Just wanted to say that.
His band was solid. His vocals were, I think as Art was saying, enough so that you knew it was him.
Yeah.
they were kind of low in the mix, but I mean, it was all right. You know, he did what he did.
I gotta brush my hair before I go. I just realized that.
That's what hats are for.
I could wear a hat today, sure.
Actually, you do.
My hat.
I probably should.
My hat. This is my hat.
Yeah.
I'll bring the alcohol. Because if anybody knows me, knows that I am like that booze queen.
Yeah.
So, and I bring coolers of alcohol to girl weekends, and we didn't even touch it. Yeah, it was hilarious.
That tracked, yeah.
Yeah. I literally had like shots and shots and beer and wine and others and alcohol. Oh man,
that's
all sorts of stuff. So yeah.
But yeah.
This is a very perfumed foundation. Smell it.
Oh yeah. Ooh.
Yeah, it's foundation and it has like perfume in it. Wow.
That's kind of weird.
And it's really orange. Sorry, I'm making things.
She's making things. But anyway, so yeah, we'll check in tomorrow morning and we'll recap today and on so on and so forth.
Yeah.
So until then,
bye bye, guys.
Bye bye.
No.
Okay.
All right. Oh, hi, guys. She's chewing right now because we're having a little break in between some music. And then I have my list. So we're gonna actually doing a recap of yesterday. So I have to find yesterday's list. So just a moment.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yesterday was started with Lockjaw. Okay. There we go.
Okay. Hey guys. So it's a little later. It's like afternoon. I said we'd do it in the morning, but whatever. Yeah, so as you said, we're taking a little break. We have about an hour before Stabbing Westward is on, which I do want to see.
Yes.
I am unfamiliar. I might it might jog something when I see him, but the name sounds familiar, but I was like, I don't know anything about him. Mm-hmm. So we're just going to recap yesterday. Mm-hmm. Yesterday was Thursday, the official first day. And it started out with tattoos.
Mm-hmm, that's right. We did get tattoos. Mine are on my legs, so. Yeah.
There we go.
That one, yep.
Got that one, and then we got added.
Mm-hmm. Mm, yeah.
We added, I don't know how well you'll be able to see that. Can't read that at all, but.
It's probably backwards. It's always an adventure.
Yeah.
We got added to our tattoos from last year.
From last year.
Mm-hmm.
So that was literally our first thing we did.
Mm-hmm. Yep. We had the first appointment. Done. So.
And then as we were getting those done, Lockjaw. Thank you.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. It was on the main stage. They opened the main stage.
Mm-hmm.
And so we heard them.
Yep.
They're from Texas, and they're as I said, they're just like Texas, like hardcore. Like,
mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's the only way to describe them.
Yeah. Oh, where's my notes? They're from Fort Worth, Texas.
Mm-hmm.
I got in my notes, heavy, good. Yes, we are awake, because they're the first band, so that's are you awake, RockFest? Mm-hmm. And then a few minutes later, are you awake? And are you awake? And I did notice there was one song where they did like, you know how like before like Rob Zombie or... before a Rob Zombie song, or there's that band that does the monster stuff, local band.
Wolf Mask.
Wolf Mask, yeah. And like Wolf Mask does a lot of like clips from movies and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
And so they did that before one of their songs. And then I just said harder, very good. But then, he's still chewing.
So we were, it was after Gabriel and the Apocalypse.
Yes.
Which we'll get
mm-hmm.
to in a minute.
Mm-hmm.
We were waiting in line to get to their merch table
because
mm-hmm. they kicked ass.
Yeah.
And I was standing behind these guys, and we were like, are you in line? They're like, no. And this dude literally just started chatting me up.
Yeah.
And, you know, saying, you know, I'm good, but I'm tired now.
Yeah.
And mm-hmm. connected to my brain, there's Lockjaw's table.
Yeah.
Oh, you must mm-hmm. be, okay.
And it's Joe. That was Joe.
Joe.
And he was chatting us
up. Yeah, and he was the guitar player because he was saying he couldn't hold on to his picks.
Mm.
And yeah, really, like, immediately we were like best mm-hmm. friends. It was strange. It was weird.
Mm-hmm.
It was good weird, but it was just, I've seen bands that can market. Uh-huh. I'm in a band that can market.
Mm-hmm.
But that was good. Like, that was.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Tank could take some lessons from him.
Oh,
for sure.
Huh? Extra networking elite level.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's so why he's like, yeah, you guys want to take a photo? Yeah. And mm-hmm. they got the band, we took a photo. It's like,
yeah.
And then it's like, well, I kind of feel obligated to buy something now.
Oh, yeah.
Well, absolutely.
Well, of course.
I mean, not obligated in that sense, but.
But just like, okay, they're really cool dudes. Like, now we want to support them even more.
Yeah,
you know?
I mean.
It's kind of how at least I was, you know.
And yeah, yeah.
I think you too. It's just like wow, they're like really cool. Like, oh, okay, let's just, you know. And it's funny because they were like, you know, you guys have your thing with like Minneapolis and St. Paul. We have thing between Dallas and Fort Worth. Mm-hmm. And they're like, Fort Worth is so much better. Dallas sucks. Mm-hmm. And so mm-hmm. it was just like funny that, you know, but it was like, it was a hilarious little tie in of how we're kind of similar in that way. But they were talking about maybe trying to come up and do some shows over in Minneapolis or St. Paul. So. Yeah, so maybe that we got that.
And then, of course, I opened my big mouth and said, oh, you know, guys, come up. We got a ton of local bands that would be great to open for you.
Mm-hmm.
And Joe was like, okay, message me and say that. And then and I was like, oh, shit, what the fuck did I do?
Mm-hmm. Yep. And then there another guy that was there that was talking us up was Justin. I remember his name.
Yep.
He was there. And then, they get the whole band out and take a picture with us. It was awesome.
Yeah, it was very awesome. They were awesome guys. They were very friendly. Mm-hmm. And they're not the first band to comment.
Mm.
Bands from out of town saying, everybody's so friendly out here.
Mm-hmm.
Like, this, like, we don't get this.
Yeah. Just that.
From wherever we're from. Like,
yeah.
And I'm like
Wisconsin's so nice.
Mm-hmm.
And Minnesota's
I'm just thinking, that's the Midwest, dude. That's mm-hmm. that's what we do.
And we'll talk your ear off. And. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's just how we do. So, okay, so then, oh, yeah. Yep, some local openers. Okay, and then, Gabriel and the Apocalypse. Mm-hmm. My first time seeing them. Your second?
Second, I believe.
Yes. Yeah. Wow. Yeah, mm-hmm. That was just insanely good. I feel like they should be bigger. Mm-hmm. Like you said they don't seem to play very many shows.
Yeah, it's kind of, but not like a steady band.
Mm-hmm.
Like they'll put out an album every couple of years and
mm-hmm.
do a few shows, but it's not like, you know.
Yeah, not real, like, yeah. So,
not real consistent, but
yeah.
Damn good.
They were really good, yeah. Awesome stage presence. And then, yeah, like a really great sound. And I just commented that it's a female singer, which I'm usually not much of a fan of. But yeah,
which
no,
you're becoming
I,
much more.
I am. Like, I guess if it's metal or harder rock, then I'm seems to be more into it. But mm-hmm. if it's your normal poppy or mm-hmm. whatever stuff, then I'm just like, meh. Mm-hmm. But yeah, no, I am really starting to find the wonderfulness in mm-hmm. female vocalists in metal and harder mm-hmm. rock. So
yeah, I was gonna say, look at Megan from Casket.
Mm-hmm.
Look at Raven
mm-hmm.
From Raven's Black. Look at Baby Butchers last year.
Mm-hmm.
Look at or 2 years ago, whenever it was.
Yeah,
you know.
So it's good. So it's really cool.
Mm-hmm.
So then, we didn't get to really meet any of them, but then we have Citizen. Oh, they're the ones that didn't have any merch. Weren't they the ones that didn't have merch?
Gabriel?
Was it that didn't have merch?
No, Gabriel had merch.
Maybe they didn't have my size. I think that's the one where they didn't have my size.
Yeah, and then you talked the dude up about the eyeliner.
Yes. Oh, that was true. Yeah. Oh, that's right. Okay.
Maybe
yeah.
defunct makeup line.
Yeah.
That she had for a while.
Yeah, I guess she's got makeup. So yeah.
Yeah, I got a t-shirt, and we got mm-hmm. CDs. And
CDs,
yeah.
That's right. Okay. See, this is why I take notes usually, because I have him. So I forget 3/4 of things without him.
Yeah, so everything she has written down, everything she doesn't have written down, I hopefully will remember.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, so I just try to take some notes to kind of jog our memories. Because
mm-hmm.
after seeing so many bands, especially in one day, like, boom, boom, boom. Like, you know, I can't remember what I had for breakfast this morning. So mm-hmm. I do now because I just said it. But, so I just try to have something that so we can remember. Oh, that's the band that did blah or whatever.
Yeah, yep.
Yeah, so then we had a Citizen Soldier. They were down on main stage.
They were main stage, yep.
I just thought they were, like, really polished, really tight band.
They were really tight. They were really polished. Once the lead singer kind of explained what he did for a living,
mm-hmm.
working with, how did he phrase that?
Like military and trauma survivors.
Well, he didn't say
kind
that. He implied that, but he mm-hmm. said, you know, I get to help treat, you know, some of the greatest people, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, then it all clicked. And it's like, okay, mm-hmm. now the name makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
Now all that makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I mean, they were good. They were tight.
Mm-hmm. They definitely do have, we lost ourselves. We gotta find ourselves.
There we go.
All right, that works. Yeah, they definitely do have some, oh yeah, and then I just did heard you
mm-hmm.
it was one of the clearest like declarations of what this band is about.
Absolutely.
That you've really seen since, like you said, since Rage Against the Machine.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I mean, I'm sure there's others, but they kind of disguise it a little bit. These mm-hmm. guys did not.
Nope.
These guys are like, we're here
mm-hmm.
to, you know, address these problems, to talk yeah. about these problems,
to help people through
help
these,
people
problems.
These problems.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and then I thought I had something else in here. Oh yeah, they definitely do seem to have a fan base too, judging by the crowd that was down in front of them and mm-hmm.
the
response
reaction,
from people. Yeah,
yeah. For sure.
They definitely do have like people.
Yeah,
that,
definitely well liked. Mm-hmm, yeah,
I know them. All right, so then next over on the the one stage was a tribute stage. Yeah.
Yep.
So it was Gravesig.
Yeah, and we've discussed Gravesig on this channel before. We've seen them. We love them. They're awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Even though neither of us are the biggest Misfits fans.
Mm, yeah. I
mean, like, you know, but you don't really have to be.
Mm-mm. I mean, you could still appreciate it and rock out and,
I think it would help if you were, because then you could
yeah.
sing along with everything.
Yeah.
But on the big core stuff, the Woes, they have a sign.
They help us.
That the Goal has,
yep.
and he'll help you. And
mm-hmm.
The lead singer is very insistent.
Oh, yes.
On you.
He wants audience participation.
You will have a good time.
You We're having will a good time. Be there. You will rock out with them. Yeah. Yeah. So that was really, really good. A little intimidating, but I told myself, you're a big girl. Just you're good. Just ride through it.
Well, a little bit when he's running through the car right next to you, when he's sitting on stage, literally 2 feet in front of you, because we're, in all the encouragement to get up, mm-hmm. we were literally
like right on
this distance
side.
From the speakers.
Yeah,
right on the side.
Which I end up at a lot, so it's amazing.
Yeah, that's kind of your
here.
Spot. So,
but
yeah, they're good. Oh. And as they joke from stage, you know, they did three sets because the tribute bands
do three sets
mm-hmm. and whatever. And they're like, yeah, this is very unusual for a punk band, like highly unusual.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, one of us might die.
And then now, of course, the crowd is like, woo, because we're all a bunch of crazies.
Yeah, and then I think you said, don't kill the drummer. And then that's when Dan said, yeah, my money's on the drummer.
Uh-huh, yeah. Like, the rule, at least for us, is don't kill the drummer.
But, as I pointed out, the singer of that band is Daniel Coppi, who is also the drummer for Reaping As Medea.
Yep.
And a fucking kick-ass drummer, too.
Mm-hmm.
And vocalist, and frontman, and just... Dude is amazing.
They were all amazing. The whole band was just, and as he said, as he introduced people, like what bands they had been or are in,
mm-hmm.
and the talent in that band is just awesome. And I've seen them before. We've seen them before,
mm-hmm.
but they do the whole thing. They do the makeup and the dude with the tall boots. Like
mm-hmm.
how you can even walk and let alone jump in those, and like that is a strenuous show. Like they were really kicking ass, like mm-hmm. all of them. And to have that, ended up seeing the third set, and that I was just like, holy shit! Like mm-hmm. they're good, so good. Like I mean, I don't even know most of the words, and I had an mm-hmm. excellent time. And
you get in that audience and it's just it's almost infectious.
Mm-hmm.
Like you can't help but like
you
know, be moved mm-hmm. by it in a weird way.
So they're really good. Just that they killed it. Okay, so mm-hmm. next was Aaron Jones up on that front stage, main stage.
Ooh. Mm-hmm. 2 years ago,
mm-hmm.
you had to miss.
Yes, I missed. I had an appointment thing, and then
and she was bummed that she missed him,
because mm-hmm.
she missed Aaron Jones and she missed Hatebreed.
Yes.
So when we saw Aaron Jones was there this year, she got all excited. And she's like, oh, I see him.
Like,
and
yay.
What did we think?
They're talented in what they do, but it was a lot of guitar wankery,
mm-hmm.
and which I do like. But like, yeah, it was like a stalling kind of it felt dragged out and stalling.
Yeah.
And like, you know, we have guitar wankery friends, you know, that,
mm-hmm.
I'm going to lose this again. Oh shit, I should have left it alone. I should have just left it alone. All right, I was trying to get you in the picture more. So we do have guitar wankery friends, but I don't know, this was just... It didn't
like show off guitar wankery. It was just like killing time and like filling space.
Yeah.
I don't know if it was supposed to be like a long intro to the songs or something, but it just felt off.
So we just ended up like leaving before they finished. It's fine. It's whatever. So,
because they were probably 10 minutes from being done.
Mm.
And I'm like, okay, they'll be done in about 10 minutes.
Uh-huh.
Do you want to head over and get a spot for Cultist Black? And she was like, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, let's go.
They're. Cultist Black is like, woo! They were over on the Boneyard.
Mm-hmm.
And so we got there, and we got pretty good. They have like a moshing area now.
First time.
Mm-hmm.
First time in 30 years of RockFest that they're allowing moshing.
Mm-hmm.
And they have it on one stage, the Boneyard stage.
Mm-hmm.
And they have a fence set up. So mm-hmm. when, I don't know if you asked or somebody asked
mm-hmm.
what that was, and I was like thinking, oh, is that like a VIP area? Or
oh something? Yeah, because I was
and then,
curious.
Oh no, that's the moshing area.
That's the mosh.
Fence them in. Okay, that works.
Which is good. Like I like it, because then you can kind of get, you could be closer to the stage, you could be in the middle
mm-hmm.
without, well, not the direct middle, because that's where the moshing was, but you could be in the middle area of the stage and still like see stuff, but mm-hmm. don't have to worry about getting killed, because there's a substantial like steel fence.
Yeah, these were like the heavy duty, like the ones that they
use at arcades
and like big shows with the steps on them and stuff. There were those in like a little rectangle in front of the stage.
Yeah, so that was that's a good idea, you know.
Yeah,
bring it in. People were moshing, but every time I got my phone up to try to, there was a couple of good moshes. Mm-hmm. Like you said, it's like they forgot how. Mm-hmm. To mosh over here, like they need to come to Minneapolis and see us and Mosher Dan and figure out how to mosh again. But yeah, there were a few where they started actually moshing, but like I said, I tried to get, I'm like, ooh, mosh, okay, and they stopped. Mm-hmm. And they did it to me 3 times, so I gave up. Mm-hmm. But yeah, Cultist Black puts on one heck of a show. So tight, so good. Audience participation, they had people crowd surfing, their percussionists went out and crowd surfed a few times, mm-hmm. And Singer did do a few selfie things, video things.
As I was telling her, as we were after they were done, because the first time we saw them was at Underground Music Cafe, if you're familiar. Smaller space. It was on the Black Hollows tour.
Yeah.
Awesome. I mean, Raven Black, Casket Robbery, and Dying Oath.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And Cultist Black. So that was the first time we saw them. Mm-hmm. And seeing them on that small stage, as I said, that did them a disservice.
Yeah.
Now, this is not like a huge stage, but it's a much bigger stage, and it came across so much better.
Yeah, they needed that extra room to kind of move and put in their, to each have their own little area, because they each kind of do their own thing. And they were just great. And they had quite a following. They had that thing packed. People were loving them. Like, they, like, people were there for them. Mm-hmm. So it was, it was really good.
And side note, as she was, when she was getting her tattoo done, I was just kind of wandering around and doing whatever. And I ran into, I saw two other people with Cultist Black shirts, because that's wearing mine in the morning. Mm-hmm. And they were like, oh, and hey. And then, the first thing they asked me if I was a guitarist. And I'm I'm just a fan. Mm-hmm. So that was cool to see. Because they were just like, you know, you're the first one we're seeing, and blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, just wait till after the set. You'll see a hell of a lot more.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yes. So then we have Killswitch, Killswitch Engage. This is my time seeing them. They're really high energy. Like, they did a lot of moving around and high energy. Really, really tight.
The singer especially was, he was moving.
Yeah, the audience, they're really, they want their audience participation, audience engagement. Mm-hmm. Holy crap, that dude can sing. Like, his vocals, like, just, and then the backup vocals even were like really like good. Like, they were just,
The guitarist on the far side.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah. Oh, the guitarist on the far side. Yeah. Mm-hmm. The guitarist too.
Yeah, he was doing like half a lead at some point.
Yeah. Like tons of talent. They all are like really talented. Mm-hmm. But that guitarist on our right, or stage left, however you want to put it, he was like singing and jumping and running and this and that and playing his guitar, which of course, and just like that, holy cow.
And just smiling the whole time.
Smiling. Like, he was having a heck of a great time. Like, so that was really fun. And then we did have, in our little reserved area, there was someone like 5 rows ahead of us that was like the mega fan.
Oh,
geez. He was dancing and singing and
running around the rows.
Yeah, running around and tucking to this person and going back and, this song, and then he was doing drumming and playing guitar and like, he was a mega fan. So he was having a great, great fan time. Like, he had a good time. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, that was fun. I love seeing people enjoying music. Absolutely. And enjoying bands and being there for it. It's like, I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it.
And just being there for it and not being afraid to be themselves.
Exactly.
Just to like let it out.
Yeah.
Just,
this is the place where I'm like, I would never usually wear shorts this short, but you know what? I don't like, there's nothing hanging out and it's hot and don't look if you don't like it.
Yeah.
So,
and you know, when we came in this morning, I don't know if you saw her, but there was a woman much larger than you in like fishnets and like a g-string and like a bra.
You can wear what you want.
Is totally cool, you know. It's just like, this is RockFest, that's what you do. This is, if you want to get weird, I guess, as far as like pushing boundary, your own personal boundaries, as far as what you wear or how you act or whatever, this is definitely the place to do it. Because I
agree. Absolutely.
Okay, before I move on, I want to do my, and this possible trigger warning for you people.
Oh.
So between Citizen Soldier and Kill Switch, there was a lot of talk about mental health and mental health issues, and don't get me wrong, I'm glad that we're in a time that we're actually addressing these, mm-hmm. and you know, this is good to get out there, and like, you know, because years ago we didn't, and there were so many non-diagnosis and mm-hmm. misdiagnosis of stuff that I'm glad that that's all happening.
Mm-hmm.
That being said, I don't think every band has to bring it up every third song.
Mm-hmm. it's a little overwhelming.
I get it, but mm-hmm. yeah, it gets a little heavy sometimes.
And it's, yeah, and kind of yeah. did like because yeah, like after like the third band, it was kind of like, ooh, like you mm-hmm. said, kind of made things kind of.
Well, and especially after like Citizen Soldier, that's like their thing,
mm-hmm.
and I get that, I understand yeah. that. And then Killswitch started with it, and I was like, mm-hmm. okay,
mm-hmm. yeah.
And again, not
dissing it.
Not dissing anything. Mm-hmm. Just, you know.
It's overwhelming. It's a little heavy.
Yeah.
Very heavy when it's like every band and then
yeah, when it's
multiple
continual,
times
yeah.
and
yeah,
it just
yeah.
gets a little like, oh, you know, not to dilute anybody's, you know,
yeah,
troubles.
and not to downplay it and not to mm-hmm. do anything like that. Mm-hmm. But
yeah, that just was our feeling kind of.
Yeah, and because this weekend, especially for us, mm-hmm. we come here every year and we try to forget about the quote-unquote real world and
yeah.
our other lives and the jobs and everything and just kind of have yeah. fun. So mm-hmm. when that's kind of presented to you.
Yeah, like multiple
times.
It just drags.
It's a drag. Yeah.
It's a bummer, man.
It's a bummer. But again, it should be addressed and I understand
yes.
that. But,
mm-hmm.
you know.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I agree.
So next up was a band we were gonna try to see some of it, but we had to come back here and we had to eat and whatever. Mm-hmm. That is Dirty Honey,
mm-hmm.
a band I was kind of looking forward to seeing. Mm-hmm. We caught a little bit of them and we liked what we heard. Like
mm-hmm.
like they're solid.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know.
Yeah. Now I'm chewing.
Sorry,
I did hear them on the radio. They were really popular a couple years ago.
Yeah, I remember when
mm-hmm.
when you mentioned them, I looked them up on Spotify and I
mm-hmm.
listened to it a little bit and I'm like, oh yeah, these guys are,
mm-hmm.
yeah, these guys will be fun to watch. And then we wound up missing most of their set, but
mm-hmm.
that's okay.
yeah.
You can't, something we're discovering very slowly
mm-hmm.
is that you can't watch everyone.
No.
It's almost impossible to
yeah.
catch every single band on this.
Yep.
In this weekend.
We're trying. We really are.
The first year we tried real hard, and that
mm-hmm.
just about killed us.
Oh, yeah. It was. Oh, gosh.
Because we're trying to film all of them and do
yeah.
all that. And,
yeah. And very limited filming and pictures, really. I'm trying to be more in the moment. I'm still taking my notes, so like I said, we can kind of remember.
Yeah, which is good. Yeah.
And
that's why we're kind of doing more of a daily instead
yeah.
of getting back home
mm-hmm.
and trying to remember the
yeah.
entire weekend. Because that doesn't end well either.
Mm-mm.
And we always forget stuff. Yeah.
Mm. So next up we had 311, which I've never seen. I'm not huge into, but you know.
I know the one album. the one album that everybody knows, the blue album from 95.
Mm-hmm.
But, and again, after Main Stage is concerned, after Citizen Soldier, after Aaron Jones,
mm-hmm.
who was kind of a disappointment,
mm-hmm.
and Citizen Soldier and Killswitch,
mm-hmm.
they came out and just did five like really upbeat kind of
mm-hmm.
bouncy, and I'm like, okay, this is what we needed.
Mm-hmm.
This is better.
Because mm-hmm.
mm-hmm. I mean, if you know 311, you know. I mean, some of their lyrics are
mm-hmm.
more like dark and
mm-hmm.
but it
mm-hmm.
underplayed by this like pseudo ska kind of bouncy
mm-hmm.
hip hop, whatever you want to call it. Sound, which is, yeah, it's just fun.
Mm-hmm. And I put, because like I said, I've never dabbled in 311, so, and this is after two of my gummies because I was hurting, but I have 311 pothead music? Question mark,
mm-hmm.
and then, yeah, and that was in the beginning. So then as we got further in and it got more trippy, mm-hmm. then I was like, oh yeah, totally, it totally is. Mm-hmm. And he's like, yeah. But I did have, it's a little, to me, it sounded a little Rage Against the Machine-ish.
Some of the heavier ones, yeah.
Yeah. And then there's, so then this is the one where they kind of started the drum solo, and it kind of reminded me of one or multiple of the drum solos that Neil Peart from Rush has done. Mm-hmm. We need to see the RIP for him, because...
RIP Neil.
Mm-hmm. And then it kind of switched the drum solo up one step, and then the two steps, and then next thing you know, the whole band is... got drums, and they're all doing their thing.
Yeah, it's kind of mm-hmm. like, oh, that's... Well, at first I just saw, I think, the singer doing it. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, okay, who do you think you are, Godsmack?
Yeah.
But then I saw a guy over here was banging like a gong or something, and then other dude was there, was doing, oh, mm-hmm. it's like... And then everybody kind of came together. And, so that was kind of cool.
Yeah.
That was kind of a highlight.
Like a whole thing. So that was really fun, and then, it did have some, like... trippy, and then you had that Sky song stuck in mm-hmm. your head, and so it was good though. It was and then we I've never seen them, and I've never really known what they look like, mm-hmm. but
it wasn't that
we were not expecting that, especially the lead singer that I don't know the name of, but no, we were not expecting him to look like he looked at all. Does not go with that voice.
Not at all.
The voice is the music. The voice is
You heard the voice and you're like, okay, that's right. Mm-hmm. But then you saw him and he looked like Timothy Oliphant, the actor, a little bit.
He looked like a preppy surfer boy.
Yeah.
And it was way weird.
It was way weird.
It was so weird.
And then at the end, he took his shirt off, and that.
And I don't like that kind of big person look. I'm weird. I'm more of a hairy, dad body dude kind of a girl. Mm-hmm. And he looked like Josh from Mythical Kitchen. I love him, but leave your shirt on, Josh, mm-hmm. because it's the same thing. I'm just like, it's not right.
And especially when. He's playing guitar, and he was like, I think headbanging, I think.
Yeah.
And then that's when all those abs came out, and we're just like, Jesus Christ.
Yeah. Yeah. It like, was way weird. Yeah. So,
nice definition on the arm, solid. Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. So that was interesting.
I mean, that, as far as main stage, I think that was kind of the highlight for yesterday.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can agree. And then, so the next was Seven Dust.
Which... they should have been on the main stage.
Yeah.
I don't know if they should have worked it out somehow. They should have been on the main stage.
Yeah.
Because if you remember our review from, was it last year?
Last year
Ginger was there?
We
talked about the crowd that Ginger had.
Mm-hmm.
Add about another 200 people to that, mm-hmm. and that's what Seven Dust had.
Yeah.
Like, it was spilling out of the tent, down the hill, almost to the little path, if mm-hmm. you're familiar with the RockFest grounds.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it there were tons of people.
Yeah, it was just, and it was just really hard to get the vibe.
Watching it on the screen,
you couldn't even see part of the stage to even try to see one person.
Well, I think
playing, if we
would have
maybe
went over, we probably could have seen a side shot of the stage, but they still wouldn't have.
Yeah, so it was just really frustrating. They really should have been on the big stage. Mm-hmm. It was just hard to kind of get the vibe. So, but
yeah, and then we found out this morning that our neighbor
mm-hmm.
Art.
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah. I'm assuming Chio was with him.
I'm not sure, but
he was in the front.
Yeah.
For Seven Dust, and kind of got caught in some motion.
Yeah.
And he's kind of like, well, I mean, you're there and you're packing tight, so you can't.
Yeah.
Really, you're just kind of stuck. You're just kind of there.
He's like kind of a mosh, but he couldn't get out of it, so he just had to kind of stand there and hold his own. So.
Yeah, just kind of had to go with it. Yeah.
You know, which sometimes you gotta. Sometimes mm-hmm. that's what you gotta do. Yeah, and then so we were waiting in our seats like good people.
So after we decided,
when I got food.
We can't watch Seven Dust, you know, it's kind of whatever. Which is the same because I was kind of looking forward to
Seven
Dust.
Me too.
Yeah. So we kind of wandered over and you kind of like almost like a home and beacon. You kind of got drawn to
so hungry to
the mac and cheese truck.
Yeah.
And we got some tots and some...
And I really wanted cheese curds, but they don't have any cheese curds in there, which was weird to me. They were, I guess, not a cheese... They were like something cheese or all the cheese or whatever. So I'm thinking cheese curds, right?
But they didn't have cheese
curds. But they had mac and cheese and mac and cheese and mac and cheese bites and tots and I think fries. So,
and then you could get it loaded with like...
Stuff.
Like barbecue meat and all kinds of stuff. Anyway, but we got...
smoked gouda
cheese bite
mac and cheese bites
thingy.
Yeah.
So a full order of the tots, which is a good probably half pound, and then like a dozen of these
at least a dozen
bites that each one was like that big. Delicious. Absolutely delicious. But so then we wandered about back to our seats and we're just kind of sitting there and chilling and eating and watching all the messages as they go on the screen and, kind of get done eating and so like okay and then look at the time and it's like 10:45 and 36 tomorrow is supposed to start 11 and I could tell that she's kind of fading and I'm kind of fading and we were just like I was just like you know it's another 15 minutes at least until they hit the stage and do we really care about 30 seconds tomorrow and we're both like no go back to sleep, go to bed. Okay. Mm-hmm. So that's what we did. We were probably asleep by 11:45.
Mm-hmm.
For sure.
Yep.
As the sounds of Reverend Leto, as I call him.
It sounded like church music.
It did. And then again, talking to our neighbors this morning, because I know Chia really wanted to see 30 seconds of March. Mm-hmm. Apparently they had like, you know, dozens of people on stage and I'm like so it was a choir essentially that we heard like I was wondering if that was tapes or not but apparently it was an actual and I could just imagine what Jared Leto would do with that
we lulled to sleep by the sounds but it was we were just like done.
It was
and never really whatever 30 seconds to Mars I might even know is whatever they might have played on the radio and then I probably don't even know all of them so all the lyrics to that so but we were just like no you know what bed we really needed bed so
and it was a good hard sleep it was
we were out
but again we were talking to Art this morning and he was talking about you know 30 seconds to Mars and I'm like I saw them like 10 years ago. I was halfway forced to go to bring one of our collective children there because he was underage or whatever and new chaperone and I'm like so I saw them like 10 years ago and it was not that it was completely different so
it's kind of weird because when we were saying but bands evolve you know
we know that and you know
just adding my so I don't forget my note there but so but it's you know it's it was not we it wasn't what we needed so we needed the sleep so we had
and sleep was good sleep felt really good
so we have energy for today
so that's it that was Thursday
yeah it was Thursday yesterday
gotta remember what day it is that helps but and then got up this morning and sunscreen and did all that and and it's all we'll tell you later
all right
that is called a teaser even though literally in the video it'll be like the next thing but that's so we'll probably do finish up some snacks and do I'll do a wardrobe change because apparently that's what I'm doing this year and then more stuff so talk to you later.